Assalamu alaikum and good morning for everyone. Today lecture about static routing. I'll present it using simple English language followed by a review using Arabic language. The main topics related to the routing process, next hop, administrative distance, metric, directly connected routes, and some comparisons between static and dynamic routing. Let us start directly using some simple topology. It contains three routers denoted by R1, R2, and R3, and four networks denoted by the IPs 10.0, 20.0, 30.0, and 40.0. Typically, PC1 cannot reach PC2 before the configuration of routing protocols in each router. In our case, we will test the configuration of static routing, which means we will use manual configuration of routing protocol. We will follow some steps. Change the router name R1 to the default router name, which is router, to the R1 symbol. The same for R2 and R3. Check the current status of routing table in each router. Here we show the implementation of SHA-IP route, which display the routing table. Two rows appears denoted by C, which means directly connected to the two networks, the left side of R1 and the right side of the R1 as a networks. 192.168.10.0 directly connected to fast Ethernet 0/0. Then the next row denoted by C, 192.168.20.0, directly connected to the fast Ethernet 0/1. The same can be checked using IP show IP routes in R2 and R3. Then check your IP configuration in each PC by IP config command. PC1 configured with the IP 192.168.10.10 and the gateway 192.168.10.1. Check the reachability from PC1 to PC2 before the configuration of static routing using ping 192.168.40.10. It will appears or displays the replay with the message destination host unreachable. It means PC1 cannot reach to PC2 currently because there is no pre-configuration to the routing protocols at each router. To solve this problem, we will add the static routing configuration manually using IP route command. IP route command needs three parameters. The first parameter is network, then the mask, then followed by next hop. For example, in R1, you need to add at least one static route to the destination 40.0, the far network, which is 192.168.40.0, the mask 255.255.250, and the next hop 192.168.22. This is the edge router. This is why we need at least one static route configuration. R2, which is the middle router, needs two at least two configuration steps denoted by networks 10 and 40. The first one, IP route 192.168.10.0, then mask, then the next hop, which is 21. It will add the reachability to the left edge network. The next row, R2, IP route 192.168.40.0, the mask, then the next hop, which is 192.168.31. This instruction required to the configuration of static route for the reachability of 40.0 network. The edge router R3 compared to R1 needs one statement at least as instruction, which is IP route 192.168.10.0, the mask, and the next hop 192.168.32. Now the three routers should be ready for forwarding the packets in both sides in our example. To check the current condition of each router after adding the static configuration using the same command show IP route, R1 the implementation of the command in R1 shows one row added to the routing table, which is here denoted by S as a static route, and the red inside the red box denoted by the network 192.168.40.0/24, then between two braces 1/0, 1 means the administrative distance of static route equal 1, 0 means number of hops, which is here by default in static route equal 0. Via the next hop interface, which is 192.168.22. Check the same in R2. The difference is in R2, two rows as a static added, denoted by 192.168.10.0 via 192.168.21, and as the next static route 192.168.40.0 via 192.168.31. Because R2 is the middle router. The edge router R3 needs one static route at least compared to others, because it is an edge router in our example topology. Then you can check the ping from PC1 to PC2. Again, it will show you the successful reachability here. Ping 192.168.40.10. The reply means or shows successful reachability from PC1 to PC2. Also, you can check the reachability using trace route to the destination 192.168.40.10. Also, it shows the hops towards the destination with successful reachability. Thank you.